Good day everyone. So today I am going to present to you the Philippine art history during the American colonialism and the different famous artworks made during that time.
From one colonizer to another, after more than three centuries of Spanish rule, the Americans came. They set out to conquer the Filipinos through education and governance, the public school system, and the system of government. With the establishment of public schools, there was an increase in demand for illustrations and cartoons for books and publications. With the influx of new corporations, advertising and commercial design were in demand and were incorporated in the curriculum of fine art schools. With the arrival of the new colonial power came a shift in art patronage from the native ilustrados to the Americans. The new patrons, including the tourists and foreign investors, favored landscapes, still life, and genre themes that show the beauty of the land and its people. Portraits were still favored by the public officials, usually depicting them in dignified poses. After the devastation of World War II came the period for rebuilding. A new republic was in place. Different art forms emerged and became popular, like printmaking. The conflict between the conservative Amorsole school and the modernist continued. The 60s and the 70s became a period of experimentation and exploration of new media, techniques, styles, forms of expression, and concepts in art. It also marked the increased consciousness of visual artists to bring their art closer to the people through forms like murals, prints, and cartoons. World War II halted all these developments. In response to the Japanese propaganda, according to Dr. Alice G. Guillermo, Filipino painters reacted by producing the following works: paintings that may be implicitly supportive of the Japanese occupation, such as Vicente Alvarez Dizon's A Day Begins, done in 1942. Genre scenes that seem neutral, such as Crispin V. Lopez's Baguio Market, made in 1943, showing Japanese soldiers interacting with women vegetable vendors. Paintings that bring out national identity, such as Emilio G. Santiago's Christmas Eve, made in 1942, which shows a traditional Filipino scene that evokes nostalgia. Paintings alluding to the social conditions of the time, such as Pilar M. Santiago's Evacuees, made in 1941, Ireneo Miranda's Home from Work, made in 1944, and Simon Saulog's Conspiracy, made in 1943, which shows a group of men in an evening meeting, which suggests to the underground anti-Japanese movement. Amorsolo's sketches of war scenes and his famous planting rice scenes, which do not depict any of the atrocities happening during those days. Paintings depicting war atrocities like Demetrio Diego's Capas, Diosdado Lorenzo's atrocities in Paco, and execution at the cemetery, and Dominador Castañeda's doomed family. All these paintings were done after the war. Therefrom, the American colonization brought high influence to the major Filipino art forms, architecture, paintings, and sculpture.
So that's it. That's how the American colonialism affected the Philippine artworks during that time.